Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As you know, there are just days left in the month of Ramadan. So as Ramadan fatigue sets in, how do you beat it and make sure that you finish strong? So first off, it's important to understand that it is normal to feel fatigued at the end of Ramadan. You know, we may have the feeling that there's something wrong with us, or the shaitan may try to convince us that there's something wrong with us, that we're feeling tired and fatigued. And, you know, we may look at other people and say, look, they're working so hard at the end of Ramadan and we, you know, we're feeling tired. Maybe there's something wrong with our faith, something wrong with our iman. That's not the case. It is normal to feel that way, but it is important to try and fight that. It is important that we end the month of Ramadan strong. You know, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Al-a'malu bil khawatim," that matters are judged by their endings, or deeds are judged by their ending. Meaning, it's not about how this journey went so far. It's about how we end this journey. It's about finishing strong. Ibn al-Jawzi, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, "Perhaps you didn't do well in welcoming the month of Ramadan, so make sure to do well in bidding it farewell." Imam Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, "Improve the performance of what is left so you'll be forgiven for what came before." Meaning, we can still salvage the month of Ramadan. We can still make the most of Ramadan in what is left. Perhaps we didn't do well in the beginning. Perhaps we made mistakes. Perhaps we didn't do as much as we could do. We could still save all of that if we make sure to end strong. So here are three pieces of advice that you can use to end strong in the month of Ramadan. Number one, get some rest if you need to. Look, I know this may sound counterintuitive, or it may sound different than some of the other advice that you may have gotten. You know, people saying that no matter what happens, just work as hard as you can, just tire yourself out if you have to. But the reality is that our bodies, our minds, they need rest. And if we don't get rest, then we're not going to be able to finish strong. So maybe, you know, you've been working hard until this very time and now the fatigue is setting in. And now because of that, you're feeling tired. So it's important to get some rest if you need to. You know, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, "Inna li nafsika alayka haqqa," that you have a right upon yourself, or your body has a right upon you. So maybe you need to catch up on some sleep. And I'm not saying sleep the whole day, but get the rest that you need to so that you can finish strong, so that you'll have more energy when you actually spend time on your worship. Number two, plan out exactly what you're going to do in these last few days of Ramadan. Once again, you may hear people say, just do as much as you can do, but that often doesn't work. When we don't define our goals and our goals are just left vague and open, then we end up doing nothing, or we end up, you know, trying, and since the goal is so vague, we don't accomplish anything. So set goals for yourself. Set goals that are realistic. Yes, they can be slightly challenging and difficult, but make sure there are realistic goals for yourself, even if it's just a few things, but know exactly what you want to do in these last few days. Number three, and this is a little bit of a spiritual matter, but remind yourself that this day that you're in may be the very last day that you have to worship Allah, the last day that you have to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, oftentimes we just assume that we're going to get another day, and the reality is that we don't know. None of us have a guarantee upon our lives that we will make it to the next day. So if this is the very last day you have to seek forgiveness from Allah, how would you be? How many people were alive last year and didn't make it to this Ramadan? How many people started the month of Ramadan and were not able to finish the month of Ramadan? So maybe this is the only chance that you have. This is the only day or the only night that you have to seek forgiveness from Allah. And that is a mindset. You need to put yourself in that place where you can understand the reality of life. So those are three things that you can do at the end of the month of Ramadan to make sure to finish strong. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to finish and complete the month of Ramadan. Allahumma ameen. That's my advice, but I'd also like to hear from you. What do you do personally in order to get yourself to finish strong in the month of Ramadan? Leave it in the comments below, inshallah ta'ala. And once again, we will all be able to benefit. And as always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Until next time, inshallah ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.